So in this section of the SAT versus Karan, I'll be tackling SAT passages. These are usually short passages, and then slowly we'll move on to the bigger ones. So let's go ahead and give it a try. So let's go ahead and first read the passage first. Duke Ellington considered himself the greatest listener. Now, because it's in quotations, the author is being skeptic about he is the world's greatest listener. Now, since we know that, let's go ahead and move on. In music, hearing is all. Judging by the 2,000 or 3,000 pieces of music Ellington wrote, he could probably hear a flea scratching itself and put that rhythm into one of his compositions. For him, the sounds of the world were the ingredients. So the sounds were ingredients he mixed into the appetizers, main courses, and desserts to satisfy the appetite for his worldwide audience. So he made a mixture of a few things, created or pleased the worldwide audience. He wasn't averse to going out in a boat to catch the fish himself. He was raised to foul himself. But when the musical mean appeared before you, none of the drudgery showed. All right. The author most likely refers to flea in line 4 in order to... So line 4, here's the word, flea scratching itself. Well, he was highlighting Ellington's prodigious memory. No, it doesn't talk about anything about memory, so we're going to cut that off. He was emphasizing the quality of Ellington's listening. Yes, because in music, hearing is all. That's how it starts off. And by judging Ellington, he could probably hear a flea scratching. The author is kind of uplifting or underscoring the ability of Ellington to listen to music. So therefore, I would say B looks to be a right answer. Indicate interest in different animals. I know the word animal is not even mentioned here. So that cuts off. Suggests that Ellington's composition were marked by rhythmic similarities. Put rhythm into one of his composition, not all of it. And that's why I don't think that's what the author meant by flea. Imply that Ellington could be overly concerned about my... No, this is off topic. And therefore, answer choice B seems to be the best one here. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at number 7. In lines 5 to 11, the author's point is primarily developed through the use of dash. So where do we see? Is there comparison going on? Well, no. Who is he comparing itself to? Is there humor? No. But since what I think the answer should be, it's not appeal to emotions either. It's because when it says comparing sound to ingredients of food, I think it's using metaphor. So, I think there shouldn't be any exaggeration here. I think D should be the right answer, but I'm just going to circle D and move on to the next one. And then later on, we can check if I'm right or wrong or whatever that is. So let's go ahead and move on to question 8 through 9. Reading this passage. In the summer of 1911, the explorer, blah, bushwhacked his way to high ridge in the Andes of Peru and beheld the dreamscape out of the past. There, set against looming peaks clocked in snow and wrapped in clouds, was Machu Picchu, the famous lost city. This was famous lost city of the Incas. This expression popularized by, okay, we don't need to know that. Who was it popularized by? So that's served as a magical elixir for rundown imaginations. So this expression the words evoke the romanticism of exploration and archaeology at the time. But finding Machu Picchu was easier than solving the mystery of its place in the rich and powerful Inca Empire. The imposing architecture attested to the skill and audacity of the Incas. But who has lived at this isolated site, and for what purpose? Question 8. The word magical elixir primarily emphasizes the romanticism of exploration and archaeology. So, I think that it wasn't the motivation to put this into another words. It could be it could just be a phrase or something that captivates or just captures the traveler's mind. So, complexity of an expression, no. Creative dimension of archaeology, no, we don't want to use words that are used in the passage, because most likely what people do on the SAT, oh, this word is here and this word is here, therefore D must be the right answer, and SAT is really smart in that. So you want to cancel those options that have the certain copy-paste words in it. Inspiration behind a discovery. There wasn't any discovery, I think. Captivating power of phrase. There we go. I should have started with B. Okay. Number 9. The mystery discussed in line 10 to 13 is most analogous to that encounter in which of the following situation? Okay. Being unable to locate source of materials used to construct an ancient palace. No. Here we were talking about history, as in the findings of a place is easier, but actually knowing the rich and powerful thing behind it, or knowing the description or evidence behind it, how this came to be, is very hard. So, unable to reconcile archaeological evidence with mythical description of an ancient city. Yeah, it does make some. Okay. No, it does not make sense. Because although you are unable to reconcile archaeological evidence, but you have to find something else that is that you are able to find. You can't be unable to find both of the things. So that cuts off. Being unable to explain how ancient people constructed imposing using primitive. No, this is completely off. Being unable to understand religious function of a chamber found inside an ancient temple. That's correct. Well, in this, you are unable to understand religious function, but you are inside the ancient temple. As in, this people who, actually the author, who is inside the city. Inside the city, that could be, let's say for example, this could be a temple. The author is inside that temple, and he's talking about mystery, about how he's unable to understand rich and powerful Inca Empire. And here, the author is just, since it's an analogous situation, he's just unable to understand religious function. So, I think answer choice D makes the most sense to me, even without reading E, but let's go ahead and look at that. Being unable to discover any trace of civilization repeatedly mentioned by A. No. So E is not it, and I think D is the right answer. So let me go ahead and pause this video, check the answer, then tell you guys what. Alright, so I checked it and I got everything right. The four questions that we did together, I got it right, and I think it's a good practice to make annotations while you're reading a passage because that's actually what it helped me get the right answers. So as far as you have annotation and understand the meaning and purpose behind the passage, I think you are good to go. So let's go ahead and talk about something else in another video, and for this video, it's completed, and all I have to say is thank you for watching.